Welcome back everyone, this is Shivani Garg. In the previous lecture we have studied the modified Euler's method for solving sink equation. In this lecture we will be studying the Runge-Kutta method for solving sink equation. So let's get started. So Runge-Kutta method is the most powerful method for solving the sink equations. In this method, the changes in dependent variables are calculated from a given set of formulae derived by using an approximation to replace a truncated Taylor series expansion as it was done in modified Euler method. First, we will consider the general Runge-Kutta method and then we will apply it into the swing equations. So for this, for general Runge-Kutta method, let's assume two differential equations as we have done in a modified Euler method also. Dx by dt is equal to f of x, y and t, and dy by dt is equal to fy of x, y and t. So let's assume some initial values of x, y and t as x naught, y naught and t naught, and a step size of h. The updated values would be x1 is equal to x0 plus 1 by 6 into k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus, 2K, plus k4, and y1 is equal to y0 plus 1 by 6 into l1 plus 2l2 plus 2l3 plus l4, where k1 is equal to x of x0, y0, t0 into h, that is step size, and k2 is equal to fx into x0, fx of x0 plus k1 by 2 in y0 plus l1 by 2 t0 plus h by 2 into h. K3 is equal to fx of x0 plus k2 by 2 y0 plus l2 by 2 t0 plus h by 2 into h. K4 is equal to fx of x0 plus k3 y0 plus l3 t0 plus h by 2 into h. Similarly, L1 is equal to fy of x0, y0, t0 into h. L2 is equal to fy of x0 plus k1 by 2, y0 plus l1 by 2, t0 plus h by 2 into h. L3 is equal to fy of x0 plus k2 by 2, y0 plus l2 by 2, t0 plus h by 2 into h. L4 is equal to fy of x0 plus k3, y0 plus l3, t0 plus h by 2 into h. So now using the Runge-Kutta method for solving swing equation, we can use those formulas. So as we know that the swing equation is d to del by dt square is equal to pa by m, we can write this into two first order differential equation as we have already done in modified Euler's method also. So we write first equation as d del by dt is equal to omega, and second equation would be d omega by dt is equal to pa by m, where pa is equal to pm minus pe and pe is equal to pmax into sin delta. So d omega by dt would be equal to pm minus pmax sin delta by m. So let's assume the initial values of delta, omega and t as delta naught, omega naught and t naught, and a step size of del t seconds. Then the formulas after the first iteration would be del 1 is equal to del naught plus 1 by 6 into k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus k4, and omega 1 is equal to omega naught plus 1 by 6 into l1 plus 2l2 plus 2l3 plus l4. These are the equations that we have seen in Runge-Kutta method for general form. So as you already know, here the k1 is equal to f of x, x0, y0, t0 into h for generalized form, and in our case, that is for swing equation, we have assumed a step size h is equal to del t, and here fx of x0, y0, t0 is the function of first equation, which is here d del by dt is equal to omega naught. So we can calculate the value of k1 as k1 is equal to omega naught del t. Similarly, we can find the values of other constants also as k2 is equal to omega naught plus l1 by 2 del t, k3 is equal to omega naught plus l2 by 2 into del t, k4 is equal to omega naught plus l3 del t. Similarly, we can find the other constants also. L1 is equal to in generalized form, L1 is equal to Fi of x0 y0 t0 into h. And again here we have the second equation, d omega by dt is equal to Pm minus Pmax sin delta by m. So we can write here as L1 is equal to Pm minus Pmax sin delta naught m into del t. Similarly, L2 is equal to Pm minus Pmax sin delta naught plus k1 by 2 upon m into del t. L3 is equal to Pm minus Pmax sin delta naught plus k2 by 2 by m into del t. And L4 is equal to Pm minus Pmax sin del naught plus k3 by m del t. Similarly, we can calculate the values at next iterations until we get the convergence values. Thank you.